All right. I hope everyone's having an awesome day. It's a beautiful morning. A little coffee talk. We're going to talk about collapses, why you'd even want to prepare for something that you don't understand or don't see. You see, that's an interesting concept because in 2006, I seemed like I was losing my mind around everybody that I knew. Everybody. I lost a bunch of friends, and honestly, they weren't really friends. Obviously, if you don't want to take the time to listen to somebody and you consider them a friend, they're not your friend. You're not their friend. But I was running around selling off all of our real estate and screaming, run for the hills, sell all your real estate. We're going to have a real estate collapse. Now, a lot of people today would say, well, it wasn't that bad. Well, they're an idiot because they don't really remember. Because idiots, I'm just going to be honest with you, people, you know, get so offended sometimes. But I think it's time for some straight talk because we're now in the next collapse. And idiots continue to do the same stupid thing over and over and over again. And real estate cycles and economic cycles are exactly that. They're cycles. That means they make a full circle. They come right back around. You got your ups, you got your downs. I'm sorry to say that. And you know, it's funny because all the people that I know that lost their homes in 08, you know, are going to the barbecues crying and complaining and so upset, and they lost their work and stuff, well, they're all right back. So a lot of people would say, see, ain't that bad. We're right back. Shoot, we probably even got more toys than we, than we can afford now. But the facts are, is all those toys cost more, the loan terms are longer, and they're even in more debt that they are than they were last cycle. But because people, human beings, are eternally optimistic, they go, look, it's good. That was a one-off. Well, now we're here. We are actually collapsing. Remember, the banking collapse started in September of 2019, evidenced by the interbank lending rate going to 10.5%, which is almost 50% worse than what it did when the Lehman Brothers collapse happened in 2008 and what happened in 2001, around 9/11. Now, we are also, it's funny because I talk about why should you prepare for something you can't see. The reason why most people can't see it because they go, look, ninja, please. Home prices are soaring up. Stock market is super high. You feel rich, right? But let me tell you a story about feeling rich in a collapse and why you need to have a 50,000 foot approach when you're looking down on the economy and what you need to do about it. I moved in when I was selling all my homes. We obviously have to live somewhere, right? I own a home right now. I'm not worried about it. Regardless of my financial status, like let's say people go, well, look, you might have more money than I, or I might have less money than you. Let's just put it this way. You got to live somewhere, right? You got to pay rent, or you got to pay a payment, or you got to live somewhere and pay taxes because you paid your house off. I covered all the bases there. In 2006, I knew the market was collapsing. We were selling all of our homes, both our flip homes, obviously, because they're flips, and we were selling off our duplexes and fourplexes. And we kept three properties. Well, one of those I bought in late 2005, early 2006, and I knew that the market was collapsing. And you might say, well, why would you buy? You're literally buying at the top. And I said, well, I've got to live somewhere, right? So we bought, and the home collapsed about 50% of its value. Now, that's in California, okay? There was some worse, there were some not as bad. Across the street from me, there was a couple that had owned a successful construction company. They actually had a construction company for, I think I want to say like 30, 35 years in a large city in California. And they were very, very successful. They had funded their own retirement, you know, multimillionaire status, I'm sure, just from, you know, some of the talks we would have. And they lived across the street from me. Now, they hadn't paid off their home, but they'd had, you know, at least a million, if not two, in the bank, in the form of a, you know, in stocks. So I came in, I was talking about the market collapse, and they were rolling their eyes at me. And one of them said once, you know, over months of us becoming friends, and one of them said, you know, it's people like you is the reason why we have market collapses. And I was completely shocked. I went, what are you talking about? And they said, it's your negativity that brings down. When enough people are negative, that's what brings down the market. It's like they all sell and that's it. And us positive people are holding the bag. I go, no, you're You're so mistaken. See, I'm telling you that this is collapsing before the stock market's going down, before housing prices are going down. They're actually going up right now, but it's collapsing. Inventories are drying up at a rapid pace, and just like they are now. And so within about 6 months of us living there, the stock market started to fall, and it started to fall hard. And what happened is every month they would look at their retirement savings that was in the stock market, and it would drop, you know, 5%, then another 5%. And they went, every month they had to go pull money out to live, to survive on. And they got scared and they went, oh my gosh, we have to. And after like 6 months, a year of this, they had to go back to work. So here they're both fully retired. They worked like 30 plus years in construction. That's hard work. I know what that's like on your body. And they both had to go to work. So they both took jobs at the local school. One became a janitor, one became a secretary. They went from owning their own corporation. I wanna say he had over like 35, 50 employees. It was a good sized construction company. To becoming a janitor and cleaning up after kids. Now, I'm not dissing on being a janitor or being a secretary, right? Because I used to own a home cleaning business and I used to make very good salary in California, and then I went to go clean people's homes. So I've cleaned toilets and stuff while making six figures in another job just so that I could take that money and invest, okay? So I'm not dissing on anybody. But I'm gonna tell you what, that does something to you psychologically. When you work so hard for 30 years and then you're forced to go and take any job. And back then, in 2000, by 2008, it was hard for them to get a job that they would like. Let's say, it was a difficult decision for them. They worked that job until just last year. Just last year. Now, we currently aren't speaking because a few years ago, I was warning them, the next crash is coming, the next crash is coming, get ready. And they didn't like that. Just like I lost a bunch of would be called friends in 2006 because they thought I was jealous. I'm telling, sell your houses, like this is happening. They didn't want to speak to me either. And the sad thing is they worked literally an additional 10 years. 10 years. I mean, that's like 40 years, 40 plus years of your life working. And now they're like, okay, we can retire now, right? And we're about to repeat that cycle again. See, the thing is the reason why I say you need to prepare sometimes when you don't even understand is because right now the best preparation you can do is to watch more of these videos by people that are way smarter than me that have been out warning. Like, I'll give you an example. Go watch Peter Schiff. If you're into cryptos, you probably don't like Peter Schiff. I'm gonna tell you what, that guy was bashed in the late 90s and he was right in 2000. He was bashed in the mid 2000s and he was right about the crash. And now he's gonna be right again. Because he understands something that very few people understand. He has a very broad view of the economy, and it's not just one thing or two things that takes down the economy. It's a myriad of things, and you have to understand them all. Well, since you might be going, hey, Ninja, I'm just me. I just work at a car dealership. I work at a restaurant. I manage a store. I'm not an economist. That's right. But for the first time in the history of the world, you can literally turn this thing on, this cell phone on, and go watch a Harvard economics professor teach his class. And you don't have to go to Harvard. Think about how powerful that is. That's why you have to get to that point now. Keep spending time watching videos. And I don't care what videos you watch. I mean, it's probably better you don't watch my videos. Come on, go find smarter people. I'm just trying to bring you the logic of why you need to be doing this. All right, guys, with that being said, I hope you guys got something out of this. These are the days. The food crisis is coming. I see it by the summer. Food prices rising so fast, your head will spin. And that's gonna cause a lot of damage in the economy because people are gonna stop buying fancy things. They're gonna stop buying video games. They're gonna stop buying lumber. They're not gonna build the shed. All right, guys, with that being said, we'll talk to you later. Economic Ninjas out.